Hi, this is Wendy Lightheart, and in this lesson, we're going to look at how to add real numbers. So first, recall the real number line. On the real number line, we have 0 in the center, and then to the right of 0, we have positive numbers, and to the left of 0, we have negative numbers. Imagine a rock climber starts out at an elevation of 5 meters below sea level, so that would be represented by negative 5 on the real number line, and then ascends 8 meters. So ascends means he's increasing his elevation, so he is adding 8 meters to his current elevation of 5 meters below sea level. And we want to know, what is his elevation now? So if we're adding a positive number, we're going to move in the positive direction, which is to the right. So we start at negative 5, and we move to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units to the right. And notice that we end up at positive 3. So positive 3 would be above sea level, and so his elevation is 3 meters above sea level. So the math problem that we just solved using the real number line is we found that negative 5 plus positive 8 is equal to 3. Suppose we want to add a negative number instead. For example, let's find the sum 4 plus negative 9. Now, when we added a positive number last time, remember we moved in the positive direction, which is to the right. So, as you would expect, to add a negative number, we'll do just the opposite. We will move to the left whenever we're adding a negative number. So when you add a negative number, you move in the negative direction, which is to the left. So we're going to start at 4, and we're going to move 1 unit to the left, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and we end up at negative 5. Thus, 4 plus negative 9 is equal to negative 5. So we're going to look at those steps again for adding real numbers using the real number line. But first, let's review an important concept called the absolute value. By definition, the absolute value of a number is the distance that number is from 0 on the real number line. And the notation we use is that the absolute value of a number n is denoted by n in between two vertical bars. So for example, the absolute value of 5 is 5, since the number 5 is 5 units from 0 on the real number line. And the absolute value of negative 3 is positive 3, since negative 3 is 3 units from 0 on the real number line. So note that the absolute value of a positive number is itself, and you can find the absolute value of a negative number by simply stripping off its negative sign. Now let's review how to add real numbers using the number line. So let A and B represent real numbers. Then to find the sum A plus B using the number line, we first start at A, and then if B is positive, we'll move B units to the right. If B is negative, then we'll move the absolute value of B units to the left. And if B is 0, of course, we'll just stay at A. Then our last step is that the number where we finish on the number line represents the sum of A and B, or the result of A plus B. So now pause the video for a moment and see if you can find the following sums using the real number line. And then when you hit play again, I'll reveal the answers. Let's see how you did. Negative 2 plus negative 5 is negative 7. Negative 4 plus positive 6 is positive 2. 7 plus negative 9 is negative 2. And lastly, negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3. Now let's look at another way you can think of adding real numbers, using what we call an ion model. Chemical atoms or molecules contain charged particles called ions. Some ions have a positive charge, while others have a negative charge. Each pair of ions, consisting of one positively charged ion and one negatively charged ion, results in a neutral charge we call zero. Suppose we want to use this model to find the sum 4 plus negative 6. So this is how it works. Here's our atom or molecule. And this atom or molecule has four positive ions. And then we're going to add to that six negative ions. So this represents 4 plus negative 6. Now we're going to use the fact that each pair that consists of one positive and one negative results in a neutral charge. So if we combine this negative and positive, that becomes neutral. This positive and negative becomes neutral. And this pair becomes neutral. And this pair becomes neutral. Now we've run out of positives, so we have no more pairs. And we're left with two negative ions. And so this is the net result of adding four positive ions and six negative ions. And so this tells us that 4 plus negative 6 is equal to negative 2. I think this model is really useful for trying to add and subtract, trying to add positive and negative numbers. And that really it has to do with the net result. So if you have positive 4 plus negative 6, you can think of it as having 4 positives and 6 negatives. And there are 2 more negatives than there are positives. So your result net charge would be negative 2. Now let's use this model again to find the sum of negative 4 plus negative 6. So here is our atom or molecule. And we start out with 4 negatives, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to add to that 6 negative charged ions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now notice that since we're adding negative 4 and negative 6, there are no positives to pair up with any of these negatives. And so our result net charge is that we have 10 negatives. So when we add negative 4 and negative 6, we end up with negative 10. So I like to think of it as I have 4 negatives and I add 6 more negatives to that. That gives me a total of 10 negatives, or in other words, negative 10. Now, you probably have noticed the pattern so far, so we're going to come up with a couple rules that help us remember what those patterns were so that we don't always have to go back to the real number line or the ion model to do our adding or subtracting of real numbers. In fact, it would be difficult to do the ion model if you were working with decimal numbers or fraction numbers, for example. And on the real number line, it would be very difficult with really large numbers to use the real number line. So we're going to have to get away from those models eventually. And these are the patterns that we need to use. So when we're adding two numbers having the same sign, we first add the absolute values of those numbers together. And then we use the common sign as the sign of the sum, or are the sign of our answer. So for example, if we're adding negative 3 and negative 7, those both have the same sign. Those both are negative numbers. And so we're going to add their absolute values together first. So that would be adding 3 plus 7, which gives us 10. And now we'll use the common sign as the sign of the sum. So our answer becomes negative 10. And again, you can think of this as we have 3 negatives, we add 7 more negatives to that, and that will give us a total of 10 negatives. Let's look at another example, this time with some decimal numbers. So we have negative 3.2, and we're going to add to that negative 1.5. So they're both negative numbers. So we're going to add their absolute values together. 3.2 plus 1.5 equals 4.7. So that's going to be the number part of our answer. And then remember that we use the common sign, which is a negative sign, as the sign of our answer. So our answer becomes negative 4.7. Now let's look at the rule for adding two numbers having opposite signs. So instead of adding their absolute values, when they have opposite signs, we need to subtract the smaller absolute value from the larger absolute value. So basically we're finding the difference between the two absolute values. Then we use the sign of the number with the greater absolute value as the sign of our sum. So for example, if we're adding negative 13 and positive 7, notice that those two numbers have opposite signs. So we're going to take their absolute values and find the difference between them. So 13 minus 7 gives us 6. So 6 will be the number part of our answer. And then the sign will match the sign of the number that has the greater absolute value. So negative 13 has a greater absolute value, and since it's negative, that means the sum is also negative. Let's look at another example. Let's add negative 46 to positive 18. These both have opposite signs again. So we're going to find the difference between their absolute values. So we take 46 minus 18 and we get 28. And then since negative 46 has the bigger absolute value and it's a negative number, that means our sum must also be negative. So our answer becomes negative 28.